Well, my computer locked up again in exactly the same way it always did when I tried to stream Fallout 4. I feel like this shit happens anytime I try to stream a game that's not like an emulator or an indie game. It's like 2D. Like anytime I try to stream something that's even a little bit taxing on the video card. It causes my computer to just flip out. Well, that's a dangerous sign. Just a random dismembered bark scorpion laying around. Yeah, it was just a total lock up everything. Like, the image was frozen on my screen, all of my USB devices no longer were getting power. You know, I heard a pop in my headphones as my microphone turned off. Everything. Probably a bad sign. Maybe I should just stick to playing emulated games forever. Like, my computer's not that bad. I mean, my video card is a few years old, but it's not like I'm not running on some sort of laptop here. I mean, I can play, you know, modern quote-unquote AAA games at 1080p, 60 frames per second, just fine. Not on the highest quality settings or anything, but you know, if it's good enough for that, it should be good enough to stream an 8-year-old game. And I never had these kind of issues when I was just playing. Who needs binoculars when you have VATS? They're the best binoculars of all, as long as the thing that you want to look at is an enemy. I guess I never had any issues when I was playing PUBG, when I was streaming that. That's a new game. I'm sort of disinclined to stream any 3D game at all, just because of bandwidth limitations. Like any game, especially first-person games, I feel like look extremely bad for people watching them unless the person streaming has just insane amounts of upload bandwidth so they can stream at like 10,000 bits per second or something. Of course, then the person watching has to have a good enough internet connection, but that's kind of the reason I mostly stick to, you know, 2D games. But I wanted to play some Fallout. Yeah, Barony probably looks okay. And Minecraft, you know, those kinds of, you know, block games where there's not a whole lot of detail going on. Oh, it's these assholes. Hey, why'd you set the town on fire? True to Kaiser.
Don't worry. I won't have you lashed to a cross like the rest of these degenerates. It's useful that you happen by. I want you to witness the fate of the town of Nipton, to memorize every detail. And then, when you move on, I want you to teach everyone you meet the lesson that Kaisar's Legion taught here, especially any NCR troops you run across. Where to begin? That they are weak, and we are strong? This much was known already. But the depths of their moral sickness, their disillusion, Nipton serves as the perfect object lesson. Nipton was a wicked place, debased and corrupt. It served all comers, so long as they paid. Profligate troops, powder gangers, men of the Legion, such as myself. The people here didn't care. It was a town of whores. For a pittance, the town agreed to lead those it had sheltered into a trap. Only when I sprang it did they realize they were caught inside it too. I think your eyes will see more than I could ever tell you. Take your time. Enjoy the sights.
I think these might be the bad guys, everyone.
You'll pay for that.
Whoa. Dude has a chainsaw. I'm going to have to reload my save, but you know, I just wanted to give these guys what for, or at least try to. I'm actually surprisingly surviving longer than I expected. Oh no! My weapon broke. Okay, well this will give me a chance to see what that actually means. Okay, so I still have it. I just need to repair it.
Retribution.
See what turbo plus one does. Okay, so it just kind of slows down time for everyone except me. That's kind of cool. At least I killed the leader. That was kind of cool. But yeah, I don't think it's possible to be powerful enough at this point to actually kill everyone here. There's just too many of them. It doesn't look like that many. There's also the dogs that I have to contend with. I don't know what the strategy is for hand-to-hand combat with people who block a lot. Like, I don't know if I just need to... Like, I don't know if I just need higher skills. Do I have my shit equipped? Well, let's go on ahead and use Hydra. I think I might not have had my... Yeah, it didn't just automatically switch to my boxing tape when my weapon broke. So yeah, even with a shitload of dynamite, I don't quite have... Like, even when I had guns for this part, I still didn't really do that well. Like, I think these guys might be artificially strong for the stage of the game. Now, if I had my bladed gauntlet, or more bladed gauntlets, then I might have a better chance. Oh, just random scorpion. I'm a little woozy. Turbo's pretty cool. Yeah, it looks like they're getting health back. I think it might just not be possible to kill them at this stage. Just kind of a bummer. I mean, it wants you to have the big... You know, the big moral quandary, I guess, of do I support the Legion or do I support these other questionable people? And if you're just enemies with the Legion from the get-go, I guess it removes that aspect of it. Who the hell is Oliver Swanick? I wonder who the random dude in a business suit was. So yeah, Cold Cold Heart is the quest that you get if you want to go down the Caesar's Legion path. I don't know what that other quest was. You know, for only having an explosive skill of 8, not doing too bad. Okay, so Caesar's Legion hates me now, which I am totally okay with. Aw man, look at all this stuff. This is basically the equivalent of beating a Dark Brotherhood person early on in Morrowind. Just the stuff that they have is so valuable that it is well worth doing a little bit of save loading, trying to take one of them out. I wonder if I got their actual leader or if he got away somehow. I kind of wasn't paying that close attention, to be honest. I was just trying to survive. So what was that other quest that I failed? let's see. Quests. Spread word of Legion atrocities. I mean, I can still do that. Just because I killed them doesn't mean I can't spread word of that. It's like, hey, they did this fucked up shit, and I made sure they got what was coming to them. Oh. I don't know what that other quest that I lost was. Or a quest that I failed. Weird. I'll have to go back and check the tape and then look that quest up in the wiki. Alright, well, took me a couple tries, but I actually managed to kill them all, I think. That's something that I was never able to do in my previous playthroughs. I need to find all of their bodies so I can loot them, because they have very valuable things. And I used quite... I burned through quite a bit of my supplies. Oh, it's a good guy.
Did you see that? That crazy bitch just attacked me out of nowhere.
Did you see that? I just killed like 7 of Caesar Legion assholes.
Not for long. I met her on the road a few days ago, and we've been traveling together since. We'd actually been flirting a little when she suddenly pulled a gun out and began yelling at me to hand my caps over. Now that I think of it, though, she laughed when I threw her my money. I think what she really wanted was my Lucky Charm necklace. Yeah, every once in a while you can find a cap with a blue star on it. They're pretty rare, so I started collecting them. Once I had enough, I made a necklace out of them, since I thought they were lucky. I will. That's the last time I pick up a straggler on the road, believe me.
Wait, people just love running up to me randomly and telling me about blue star bottle caps. Like, I did the quest line that involves those. And the thing that you get really isn't that mind-blowing. It's just like a good gun. I'd really rather not get poisoned if I had the option. Hey Thomas, can you deal with that bark scorpion for me? Okay. Alright, well. Right, they were having some sort of lottery in this town to see who lives and who dies. And Caesar's Legion came to, like, punish them for that? Or something? I don't know. I mean, I got the little Wild Wasteland icon. And the little music sting. There must be some sort of plot line involving this. Yes, okay. I wasn't sure if I actually got Vulpes or not, but I did. Ooh. Alright, well, I feel pretty accomplished. Boy, my armor took a beating, though. Must have been that Ripper. Yeah, this thing just straight up ignores your armor. It's a good weapon. It's too bad I am devoted to my fists. milsurp. I guess military surplus. That's not a very badass sounding name. Milsurp. I wish my light wouldn't turn off every time I change areas. Let's see, do I have any water on me? Good water? Yeah. Go ahead and take care of that. Oh yeah. Look at me. I'm the fucking Caesar now. What do you say to that? I like the glasses are just part of the wolf hat or the blindfold or whatever that is. Well, I can't spread word of the atrocities now, so I don't know what I need to do. I have anti-venom, so I'm not so worried about fighting these things now. These things don't have poison glands or anything. So it's going to. Like I said, I did get poisoned. Damn it! Didn't say I got poisoned. Oh well. Or maybe it did, and I just missed it. Those messages that pop up in the top left-hand corner, they're not the easiest thing in the world to see in the heat of battle. And they don't always pop up when they should, and sometimes messages that you don't actually need pop up there. Not a very good system. That's a good thing I got all that dynamite. I definitely wouldn't have been able to kill all the legionnaires if I didn't have a good supply of dynamite on me. Alright, so where to? Right, I still need to go through Novak. I wish I could just mark quests as ignored so they just don't show up in the list. There are a bunch of quests I don't care about on here. Let's see if I can repair this robot. I might have taken the wrong skill on my level up that I need for this, but it's okay. There will always be more levels. So yeah, if I had a science of 55, then I could have gone on ahead and repaired it. Which I don't think I would have been able to get that on my last level up anyway. Yeah, my science was only 32, so best I could have gotten it to was 47. Oh well, there will always be opportunities later.
Hey there.
And I can't repair the sheriff yet, right?
Any luck finding a suit? All right. Hey, youngster.
Okay, so I just need a repair kit, and my bladed gauntlet will be usable again. I would just worry that it would, like, if I let it break, it would be gone forever. I don't know if I want to hang on to the lottery tickets or not. I know that they're important for something. I just don't know what. Man, these books weigh a lot. I need to dump those in my dumpster while I'm here. Do you actually have anything I want to buy, though? Not a whole lot. Wonder glue, wrench, scrap metal. Yeah, I should not sell the ripper to him. All right, there we go.
Another satisfied customer. Yeah.
Bye. All right, where is Prim Slim? Let me see if I can dehack you.
Howdy, partner.
Okay, so, yeah, I mean, I could just make him sheriff now, but just for my own conscience, I would rather unhack him before I do that. I mean, I think that all that does practically is let me get that gun that should be in that case, or give me some sort of quest to get it, but just for role-playing purposes. So I need 50... So yeah, I need one more level. Do the magazines stack? Actually, I have no idea. I never really bothered using them. I don't think I have one for science anyway. Oh well, if I can find a bunch of science magazines, then maybe I'll try it that way. Stromback, ha. I laugh at your Strongback perk. Alright. Let's dump all of these. Because I won't need them until whatever quest giver I find that requires them. I need to just... I mean, ammo casings do me zero good since I'm not using guns. Let's see. I'm gonna sell the Ripper. Okay, yeah, it is sunglasses. You can see it in the little picture down there. I mean, I have no reason to keep wearing this, but just, you know, it's my trophy for taking out that little segment of the lesion. Alright, you can have that. You can have that. You can have that. Never did find any duct tape, which I need if I want to repair my thing. Kind of blows. Went ahead and get what dynamite I have available.
Pleasure doing business with you. Take it easy.
I know I sold someone some duct tape at some point. I guess it doesn't stay in their inventory. Let's see. I thought I had a sensor module. Wow, it only takes 10 bottle caps to make a bottle cap mine? That seems broken. I thought I had an empty syringe, too. That stuff must have happened. You know, I must have lost that when I had the crash or something. I didn't throw it in my dumpster, did I? No. I mean, as soon as I find some duct tape, I can make a whole bunch of repair kits. Is there a campfire in this town? It would be very handy if there was a campfire, like, right here. So I can just, you know, look at what I have, see if I can craft anything. If not, just throw it all back in my dumpster. Eventually, I will have an actual home. But for now, the dumpster is my home. And I don't think I can actually, like, I can't, like, make a campfire like I can in Fallout 4. I just kind of have to locate one. I forgot how much crafting stuff was actually in this game. I just never engaged with any of it. But now I kind of want to do, just because I didn't before, you know? I don't know where the closest campfire would be either. Oh well. Like, it gives me a reloading bench and a workbench right here. You would think that it would give me a campfire as well. But apparently not. Oh, that's okay. Dehydration. God, I just drank some water. Won't you ever get enough water?
How are you holding up?
Not good, Doc.
Don't. Okay. Thank you.
This guy has stuff for sale. I think it's all medical supplies. But you know, maybe, you know, in a pinch, duct tape can be used instead of medical tape.
Sure.
Find the exit sooner or later. Alright, let's just bounce down to the Good Springs source, I guess. Drink some water. Then I want to go talk to Mr. Nash one more time to see if he has any duct tape for sale. My active quest right now? Oh, right. Oh yeah, I should go back to the NCR camp and see if there are any vendors there. Someone made a mess. All right, where are you, buddy? Oh, there you are.
Hey, youngster. Still hanging about Prim, huh?
Why'd you put your gun on me? No, no duct tape here. Oh well.
Yeah, bye.
Boy, he just got really aggro all of a sudden for some reason.
Howdy.
All right, let's go check on the MCR. And then after that, I guess we'll head to Nipton and see what my next goal is. Oh, there it is, Novak. Did I not do that on this? On the save? Hang on. Haze in the NCR will protect Prim. Okay, so I did that. Okay, I'm confused. Correctional facility is where the powder gangers took over. That's where that one dude is, who I definitely don't want to be sheriff. I guess it's wasn't the Mojave. No. Also, I don't know why I have a quest marker here. There's no. Oh, this must be like the. Is this the entrance to the NCR compound or something? I totally forget where that was, and I was just there. Okay, yeah, I remember this. I remember the giant lake that I have to avoid. Oh, okay, yeah. Why doesn't this whole area get a marker and not the drive-in, which is sort of unconnected to this area? It's weird. Yeah, that's very strange. Maybe this isn't really a compound. Maybe it's just a place, and that dude happens to be there. But I mean, you have the NCR flag up there. Yeah, I guess this area is a little bit more ad hoc than I thought. I mean, I know they said they don't have enough supplies and troops, so I doubt anyone will sell me anything anyway, but I thought it might be worth checking out, at least. Yeah, it's just a couple tents. Boy, this stuff is really close to Prim. That's a very circuitous fast travel point. What's up with this thing? Okay. The NCR just has a pet gecko for some reason, I suppose.
What is it? Sir.
Yeah, I thought there would be more tents than this. Yeah, there's really not much to this area at all. Stuff actually isn't bad. Better than the armor I have. Oh. So the NCR is going to get mad at me if I wear this stuff around them. So I'll hang on to it, though, for the future. Man, that's a cool mechanic. Disguising yourself as a member of a faction to get in, but, you know, people high up in the faction will see through your disguise.
Yeah. We were sent out here to hold back the tide. As you can probably tell, we aren't doing it. The mission isn't a problem. The problem is with supplies. I'm trying to get some reinforcements here, and most people just call it a little, not much. They got her, thankfully.
Okay, so yeah, no supplies.
We won't go quietly.
Because they don't have enough supplies of their own. That makes sense. Alright. Let's head to Nipton real quick. Probably gonna have to call it soon. Well, I guess I can put that armor on now. I just need to make sure I take it off if I'm going to be around NCR people. So I can wear the face wrap armor and the helmet. I thought they would both be head slot items. That's kind of cool, actually. It looks sort of badass. Like, in a mysterious kind of, you know, man with no face kind of way. Were there any more houses around here? I thought there were. Yeah, there are a bunch. Ooh, general store. That sounds worth checking out. There's not going to be anyone running the store, but I might be able to scavenge for some supplies there. Oh, there is someone running the store. Weird.
God damn it! I was nodding off until you barged in here, and I don't hurt when I sleep. Just give me some goddamn Med-X and fuck off, will you?
Jesus Christ, dude. I thought everyone here was dead.
I don't know. I just love it here. What the fuck do you think, asshole? Prize for second place was I got to live, but they beat my fucking legs with hammers. I'm fucking crippled, get it? Then you're a fucking dream come true, ain't you? How much you gonna give me?
Do I have 3 doses? I guess I do.
3 doses? That's almost enough for a party. Luck, that's how. I'm just that fucking lucky. You're looking at the second place winner of the Nipton lottery. That asshole Swanick took first place. So him they let walk.
Oh. So that's who that guy was.
It ain't like we came to Nipton to play it. Me and my crew had it worked out to kidnap some NCR troopers who come to town to get laid. Had it all worked out with the scumbag mayor. We were gonna ransom them off, keep their weapons for ourselves, a nice score. We get in position, and next thing we know, we're surrounded by those fucking Legion freaks. They dragged us and everybody else into the center of town. And that asshole with a dog on his head, he starts talking about how we're bad people. He said we needed to be punished for what we did. Not all of us, but some of us. And then he gives everyone a fucking lottery ticket. What do you think? He started drawing tickets and that's how people got punished. First up was the lucky losers. They got decapitated. Guess that's lucky because it's pretty quick. Then came the crucifixions. God damn, but those went on and on and on. Third place runners up got enslaved. I got the fuck beat out of my legs and the winner, they let go free. Him? When his ticket came up, they burned him alive on a pile of tires.
So what you're saying is the Legion is bad. That's the message that I'm getting here.
Yeah, a bunch of those Legion fucks dragged them off right away. They were headed east, if you're feeling heroic. Don't act like you'd be doing me a favor. I don't give a fuck.
I mean, I guess I would be pissed off if I was him too, but, you know, I did kind of just, well, never mind.
What is it this time? Later.
Okay, so I thought this might be the person who is like the karma factory. Who you can give Med-X to over and over again and it'll just raise your karma. But I guess that's all I can give him. So, no benefit from giving him 3 Med-X's, but that's okay. I mean, he needed it way more than I did. Do I have an addiction right now? No. I wonder if that's something that the doctor can cure. Because after my fight with the Legion, it said I was addicted to something. I don't know what the... Alright, not a whole lot going on in here. It looks like they kind of already took everything that's not nailed down. I could probably get the key to that room if I pickpocketed this dude or killed him, but I'm not going to do that. There can't be anything that good in there. Yeah, I don't think I ever came in here during any of my previous playthroughs. It pays to look at the map. There's another... Yeah, I wanted to check out the town hall. Because you see all these houses, and there's not really anything differentiating them for the most part. But look at your map, and you can see possible points of interest. I mean, that was worth 30. I'll take it. I'm not above looting the dead, you know? You do what you have to survive in the wasteland. And people who are already dead, you know, they're not gonna miss it. Alright, let's see if I can get this mine before it blows me up. Yeah, I don't know if it actually requires a skill for that or not. You might just have to be fast enough. I'm glad I heard that explosion when I came in here. Because otherwise I might not have been looking for mines. Every time I see one of these hand dryers, I think it's a first aid box. And there's always good stuff in those. So, disappointing when it's not. Oh, hey. Shoot the tubes, dog meat. What did that say about the NCR? Was it just letting me know I'm disguised as them? Because I know that. Oh my god. It's a lot of doge. I mean, I feel bad when I hear them whimper. I don't want to beat up the doggies, but, you know, they've been... They've been trained badly. It's not the dog's fault. It's their shitty owner's fault. I think there might be a perk that's like animal handler or something that lets you tame animals instead of killing them. If that comes up, I might take it. Mantis foreleg. Poor doggies. I wish I could just give them a better life. Something to eat here. I think I have like Brahmin steak or something. Yeah. Should be enough. Alright, which piece of my armor is in bad shape? Wait, well, why was I not... Oh, okay. I see. These both fill the same slot. I gotcha. Perception minus two? Well, can't get much worse. Oh, 30? Oh, I'll take that. Nice. Damn it. Don't attack me. I'm a fellow dog. I have the hat of your master. You know, never mind that I'm also dressed as an NCR person. Does anyone else hear MCR and think My Chemical Romance every time I say NCR? Because that's definitely a thing for me. Don't I have some sarsaparilla on me? Yeah. I'll drink a couple of those. Didn't mean to do that. Wait. Oh. I saw cure animal poison. And I thought that was something they had, but that was in my inventory. Oops, I didn't need a coffee mug. That is literal useless junk. Unless you have like the junk gun where you can put random garbage in it and shoot it at people. The only thing that stuff is useful for. Alright, watch out for mines. Ooh. See, always a good thing when you see one of those first aid kits. That's it? A cabinet with a conductor in it? future weapons today. I bet that's science. Why are these lottery tickets worth 10? What value do they have now? I mean, what value do they ever have? Ooh, a science book. Science increased by 3. Nice. Oh, okay. So future weapons is specifically energy weapons. And then Programmer's Digest would be science. Alright, I reset the mainframe connection, whatever that did. Tony was kind enough to build this terminal and set it up for me, all for 30 caps worth of Rosie. Ugh. The life of a mayor suits me just fine. I'm glad I didn't go any further east. I'm making plenty of caps right here off Rosie and Sylvia, who attract plenty of interest from troops at the Mojave Outpost. Guess you spend enough time standing around that backwater and you're ready to hop on something that looks like a mole rat. Ugh. And the local shops are all giving me a percentage of sales to the troops because it's my girls who bring them in. They think they're shrewd negotiators for getting me to accept a 15% cut instead of 20%. Another year in this dump, 2 at the most, and it's back to the hub. Maybe I'll run for office there. A promising development, if I do say so myself. It seems things went to hell at the NCR correctional facility north of here and escaped prisoners are roaming free. Sounds like a bad thing, and would be, if not for the political acumen and interpersonal alchemy of yours truly, Mayor Joseph B. Stein, Esquire. I sent the gems out to make contact with the prisoners, or powder gangers, they insist on this name, to let them know that Nipton's open for trade, with free turns with... Ugh. I see a lot of potential here, so long as I can keep the NCR troops and powders... ridiculous name from running into each other and shooting it out in the streets. Luckily, the troopers only come at night. Yeah, I get it. So if the powders will only come during the day, I'll have them coming and going. See, I knew that the mayor was going to have something to do with what happened with the Legion. If there's one lesson to be learned from Fallout New Vegas, it's that literally everyone is terrible. And there are no good guys or bad guys. Because everyone's awful. The Legion is definitely worse than anyone else, though. He knew that NCR troops and powder gangers often spend time in Nipton. It turns out that the Legion hates and wishes to make an example of both groups, the NCR for obvious reasons, and powder gangers for harassing Legion raiding parties. All I have to do is convince the Powders to kidnap the NCR troops at night. They offered him 8,000 caps for that. Start stockpiling some supplies in a safe house between here and the Mojave Outpost, just in case. So yeah, it's a very morally horrible world, which, you know, is appropriate that I'm role playing as a character from Lisa and listening to music from Lisa, because the lesson of that game is very similar. There are no good guys or bad guys in Lisa. It's just varying shades of gray, which I appreciate. Alright, I'm gonna have to remember that there's a safe house between here and the Mojave Outpost. Alright, that's probably everything of value in here. Actually, I might go check that out. I wonder where those 8,000 caps are. Well, I assume that they never actually gave them to him. Some ammo to sell. it's nice being able to see ammo and just immediately convert it to money in my head. I mean, I don't have the conversion rate memorized, but just the knowledge that this ammunition is just going directly into my pocket. Once again, I found a key, and it doesn't appear to actually go to anything in here. I can't unlock that door with the key. And I don't have good enough lockpicking capabilities to do it myself. See, you need a lockpick skill of 50 to even get to the dialogue where you can force the door open. I should be able to just punch the door down. Or have some other way to get in there. Oh well. I mean, I guess not focusing on lockpicking. Yeah, I know I'm still dressed as a member of the NCR. I guess it's nice that it gives you those reminders, because I don't want to blunder into NCR territory and forget that I'm dressed like them. Just a little weird and distracting, but it's not too bad. Oh, there's the door that key goes to. Okay. Neat. I never like using mines as weapons. It's just too squirrely for me. And I didn't just say squirrely because I saw the squirrel on a stick. Like, it is actually squirrely. Because you can never guarantee that someone's going to walk over a mine when you want them to. Ooh. Yeah, coming across a stash of weapons and ammo is every bit as good as coming across a stash of money for me. Carton of cigarettes, it's pretty valuable. I mean, everyone acts like cigarettes, well, I guess the Fallout games act like cigarettes would be a valuable commodity in the post-apocalypse, but I mean, it would be relatively easy to grow tobacco and just roll your own cigarettes. I mean, I guess you would have to learn how to cure it properly and all that, but like, it's not something that only the Marlboro factory knows how to do, you know? I mean, tobacco is a pretty, you know, it's a plant with a pretty storied history. It's not like a total mystery. I don't know, maybe the radiation affects tobacco plants in a way that makes them not grow properly or something, who knows? All I know is I don't smoke, so I get paid. Boy, that fire is just kind of hell on my processing capability. So the mayor's note said that he has some sort of stash between here and the Mojave outpost. So I want to just kind of head in that general direction and just see if I see anything. I mean, there is like a little triangle here. That might be something else though. And then after that, I will probably call it. And I'm having so much more fun with this than I did with Fallout 4. Like, stories, you know, meaningful things actually happen. The writing is actually pretty good. It's interesting. Right, bark scorpion. I mean, I'd rather not have to burn through my anti-venom, so I'll avoid them if possible. Jackals. This is the game that were just automatically aggressive towards me. And there's not really anything to take cover behind out here, which sucks. Oh, I thought I saw more jackals over here. I think it's just trees or cacti or something. Oh Lord. Man, these only give me 60 health back. It's really not that much. Well, we'll see if I can kite them to some place where I can punch them better. Doesn't look like they're super interested in following me. No, there's someone. Man, life is hard when you don't use guns. Come on, asshole. I'm right here. What's wrong? Wow, that's worth a lot. This one isn't worth as much, I guess, because it's not in as good condition. I mean, it's still worth carrying around, though. Even if it is extremely heavy. How? I thought I started wearing the bandolier armor again. Oh well. I'll wear the metal armor. Agility minus one. Well, I have some bad news for you on that front. Come on. Get knocked out, jerk. Ooh, that guy has a sledgehammer. Oh. Oh, this is the Legion. Okay. That's bad. Maybe. Maybe I shouldn't have gotten on the Legion's bad side just yet. Alright, let's use some medics. Let's use some psycho. Use some rebound. Let's use a stim pack. Drink some soda. Anything else? Yeah. Oh, I don't know where I got all this turbo, but I'll take it. Oh, I was going to, No! Damn it! Oh, I guess drugs have their limitations. So it saved after I did all that town hall stuff, right? I just kind of trust it to autosave at all the appropriate times. Yeah, it did. Okay, good. Just wanted to make sure. Man, I would have had those jackals if the Legion didn't just show up. That's a bummer. Oh well, I'm not ready to give up just yet. Man, that was a Legion assassin. Like, they came after me quick. Okay, these are just birds. They're not monster birds. Let's save here before the jackals really notice me. Oh, too late. Maybe I should be a little bit more liberal with my dynamite use. Maybe I should have put more points into explosives. I didn't think I would be using them as much as I am, but when you don't use guns, you don't have a lot of options. Jerk. I still don't know how to deal with enemies that block. Maybe I should hold the button down so it's like a more powerful punch. They seem to be able to block that as well though. Oh, you know what? I'm not using my damn boxing tape. No wonder. Shit. I You know, wrapping your fists in tape, it makes a huge difference. Would you stop that, you fucking asshole? The hell? There's like a racetrack finish line or something over here. Or maybe a starting line. Yeah, Sunset Sarsaparilla, it heals almost as much as a stim pack. Just 50 versus 60. Just takes way longer. Well, that time it worked out for me because I didn't get randomly attacked by the Legion at the same time I was trying to deal with the Jackals. That was just bad luck. Well, that would be worth a few caps. Alright, so this isn't the actual outpost. At least I don't think. I mean, I just kind of stuck this marker here just because I want to walk in that general direction. There's not necessarily going to be anything there. Small rat scorpion. I should be able to deal with that. As long as it's just one. Or there's another one over there. These things are tanks. Even the small ones. I really, really need to find some duct tape so I can repair my gauntlet. What exactly does the medical skill do? Does it just make stim packs restore more health? Yeah, determines how many hit points you'll replenish. For having a medicine skill as high as it is, feels like they should be better than that. Especially for how much they cost, but oh well. I hear things. It might just be me crunching the grass as I walk. Ooh. Oh wait, was each of those an individual pinion nut? Weird. Oh no. There are just two groups of them there. Agave? Some fresh potatoes. Yeah, I saw all the empty soda bottles and I thought there might be some sarsaparilla or something in there, but nope, it's already been picked clean. Oh, right. Is this an NCR thing, or is this just another town? I remember the two statues shaking hands there. I think this might be, like, the main NCR base or something. Oh, I wish I wasn't so cavalier with my duct tape. I remember laughing because this stuff is so valuable in Fallout 4. And it turns out it's valuable here too, if I care at all about crafting stuff. I just never cared about crafting stuff before.
Need anything? Sure. Here's what I got.
Reinforced leather armor. I mean, that's what I have, but mine isn't in as good condition as this. I wonder if it would be worth buying this just to repair my armor some more. Cards that he sells don't show up under any of the categories. I thought it would be under miscellaneous, but you just have to look at his main item list for those. Weird. Alright, I have some stuff to sell here. Yeah, I don't see myself ever using mines. I'm gonna hang on to the poison glands just in case I can use them for crafting purposes. I forget if conductor is something I need. I mean, I'm pretty sure if it has the junk icon, it's not useful for anything. But then again, I mean, like, scrap electronics. I know that's useful for repairing stuff as well. I know the toaster isn't useful. I mean, my bandolier armor is as good as the reinforced leather armor. I'll sell that though, and that. Alright. I just need to actually be wearing it, which once again I am not for some reason. Alright, Y button, top. Okay. Oh, okay. So I can use the NCR armor to maintain my other NCR armor.
Hey there.
Hey there. Need anything? Sure.
Forgot to sell that. I might as well sell this. I'm sure I'll find something better by the time this armor wears out. That would be the hope anyway. Truck full of motorcycles. Thank you. Okay, so yeah, this is main NCR territory, which means I don't want to go in there while wearing my NCR armor. But I can fast travel back there anytime I want now. So if that dude did have a stash between Nipton and the NCR outpost, then it's my jam again. Then it's probably somewhere in the general direction of my marker. Maybe one of these two triangles over here. I don't know. I'll go check them out. Save real quick. The problem with the triangle on the compass system is that you have no idea what the actual distance is. Hey, what's up, Lamont? Yeah, I got turned around. I don't want to head north. Man, you would think with an endurance of 10, I wouldn't get so thirsty so quickly. I mean, it's also possible that, Mayorsnow was complete bullshit, and he doesn't have a stash out here at all, but I thought it would be worth checking out. Oh, that's like a crashed airplane. Weird. Oh, that's it. Just one solitary little ammo box. I might be able to take on a full-size... Well, I've attacked full-size rat scorpions before. It hurts, but as long as I can knock them out, I can deal with them. Maybe when my hand-to-hand is higher, I'll have a better chance of, like, breaking enemy blocks. Yeah, I'm heading back to the pit stop. Maybe the pit stop is what the mayor meant. And I just can't get into it because I don't have enough lockpick skill. Nice thing about ants is that they're slow. Alright, are you shooting at me or shooting at the ants? Whoever you are. Oops. Okay, so the jackals are having beef with the ants right now. Good. Oops. I was too far away for that to be effective. Yeah, y'all just fight amongst yourselves. It would be nice if I could target specific body parts in Vats, so I could like attack her arm and make her drop the gun. That would be handy. One worker ant I should be able to handle with my fists. Ant meat. Okay, yeah, after scouting out the area, I'm starting to think that the mayor's note meant that the stash is in the pit stop. Let me head back there real quick just to make sure I didn't miss anything there. I mean, it's the only landmark between Nipton and the Mojave outpost. Unless he meant a different outpost, which I doubt. I don't know, I kind of thought it would be a cache of guns, and all that's there is mines and grenades. Oh well. I should probably call it. I've been going a little bit too long as it is, but thanks everyone for watching. I don't know if this is of entertainment value at all to anyone, but this is practice. I'm practicing streaming right now. So those of you who get entertainment out of watching that, then I'm glad. I'm happy that something can come of it. And this is practice for the real stream, which will happen at some point in the next week, which I still don't know what that'll be. Probably not Landstalker. I don't really care that much about that game to go back. I would like to finish Creepy Castle at some point, so that will probably be the real stream. But in the meantime, look forward to more practice streams. I'm having fun doing them, and hopefully people watching are having fun watching. And if not, then, hopefully it's at least adequate background noise for whatever y'all happen to be doing. So, yeah, I will see you later. Bye.